You're live.
Thank you.
Counting seconds.
Hi. We live?
Yeah.
Bonjour, monde.
Or whatever.
Let's have a drink before we start.
Yeah, let's have a drink before we start. I think it's a good idea to have a drink before we start.
Thank y'all for showing up for another Friday COVID Courtyard Happy Hour concert with Butternut and Dee Dee. Butternut sitting on my feet, so everything's good. We hope everybody's okay, as well. I see that Christiana's here. It's good to see
you, Christiana.
Hey! Happy, welcome back to New Orleans. I'm glad you're feeling good. Let's see, what news do we have to report? Well, first of all, thanks for WWOZ. They had a big shout out today. Well, shout out. They said who was gonna be out live today, and they put me up there, which is good. And I really appreciate it. I don't know what I need is my strap, because I'm going to lose my guitar if I don't put my strap on.
The main thing this Friday is, besides all of the misinformation we're having to swim through, we want to say how sorry we are about what Hurricane Sally did to the Gulf Coast. For those of you who don't know much about hurricanes, she was fat, she was kind of unorganized, and she was slow. And so that meant that while she sat there in the Gulf, she just sucked up so much water that at one point her south side had 24 to 30 inches of rain stuck in her. And as they move across the street, across the land, they have to dump all that water. And it was a mess. For Pensacola, it looked like the bay side of the island just came to visit. So we want to send a special shout out to Renee at Paradise, right?
Hey, Mac.
For those of you who don't know the Paradise Inn on Pensacola Beach, please look them up. It's the last of the old concrete block sort of motor hotels. They have a beautiful backyard that faces the sound side, and they have live music. David plays there.
With Beausoleil.
Yeah.
Well, we used to. It's going to be a while.
However, if you ever think about volunteering for hurricane cleanup, that'd be a nice spot to do it.
Didi, can you see comments on there? Can you see
people? I'm inviting people.
I see Phil.
Dave Humdy's here. Jeff Hornstein. When's your birthday, dude? JC, welcome. What's the weather like up there? If it's cold up north, it means our summer's coming to an end. So y'all keep us posted about weather. Hornstein, I don't know if you know it or not, but y'all's snowfall last week or the week before, no, last week is what kept Sally out of New Orleans. So make sure you maintain your planet, people. You'd be surprised how important it is. Uh-oh, puppy's knocking the camera over. So once again, to the survivors of Hurricane Laura and Hurricane Sally, we extend our deepest condolences. Lost boats, lost houses, lost health. The most incredible thing about hurricanes is that it's bad enough while they're raging around, but when they leave, the weirdest accidents happen. So please be careful. Be careful out there. For those of you who are interested in supporting the victims of Hurricane Laura or Hurricane Sally, please let us know. We'll get you in touch with valid, honest people. Hey, Angela, welcome. It's Friday, girl. What you drinking?
Manhattan, old-fashioned or Manhattans.
Which maybe, who knows? We'll David's singing about plunging into the Manhattans since she sent the recipe, right?
Yeah. Haven't done it yet.
We haven't bought any bourbon yet, but we will. Bourbon's our wintertime drink around here, and we haven't gotten winter yet. Jeff, did you make your ribs, dude? Need all this information to keep going. I'd rather talk about food than...
Food's more fun. Maybe we'll play some food songs if I can.
We were going to have a theme this week. It was going to be wind.
Yeah, but it didn't work out. Plus, the application that I use with all my words, I just upgraded to the new system, the new iOS system, and that app doesn't work. So it's going to be an interesting day.
We'll so if you happens. Hear him go, la, la, la,
la, la, la, I'll be, la, that la, means I don't la. Know the words. Anyways, so I thought we'll play, let me warm up. And it seems that there's a, I don't know if it's a rumor or the truth or what, but it also, they also have said or found out that Facebook, as of October the 1st, is not going to have any, it's not going to allow any more live music shows. I don't know if that's true or not. I don't know if you got to, they'll do it till they catch you. I don't know what. So I've been actively looking for another place to do this. I would like to do it on YouTube, but I can't do it on YouTube till I get 1,000 followers. I have 22.
Subscribers.
Subscribers.
The word subscribers.
Subscribers. I have 22 right now. So I need about 978 more people at least to do that. Then we could go straight from YouTube. There's a couple other apps. I know JC signed up for one. The problem with that Twitch app is you can only do a half hour show. Unless I just reduce my show to a half hour instead of 2 hours, which is very comfortable for me to do 2 hours. Half hour is hard for me, but I could do it. There's a couple of others that I found. I'd like to do it on YouTube if that were possible. But like I said, tell your friends and you know, get about 20 different email addresses and then go subscribe to me. That would work.
All right, so to reiterate, David is actively searching for a new platform from which to have these shows. Apparently Facebook, apparently the live shows have gotten in the way of some copyright issues, which actually does make a little sense. It's not just Facebook being Facebook. However, to get YouTube, he needs 1,000 subscribers. If you go to David, what's your address on YouTube?
David Doucet.
If you go to look, search David Doucet on YouTube, there'll be a red subscribe button. If you hit that over the next week and invite other friends to hit it, if we make 1,000 people, then there's no problem.
That's
if
right.
We don't make 1,000 people, then we're going to have to find another platform. God only knows where that's going to be. Anyway, welcome. Welcome. It's Friday. Get your drink. Send me your recipes. Let's talk about everything. And to Pensacola and Mobile, we're so sorry. And everybody else in between.
Good job. Skies are gray. You'll never know, dear, Oui, mon soleil, mon unique soleil.
Keith Krabby, how are you doing today?
Whoa, Keith is there. Keith. Comment ça va, Keith? You still live in the French Quarter or are you back in Thailand? Or Vietnam? Where the hell were you living,
man? I want to go there. Actually, I could go to all three. French Quarter, Thailand, Vietnam. I don't even care. Does anybody miss traveling as much as I do?
I think we all miss traveling.
Oh my God.
It's gonna come back someday. Patience. Don't get complacent. Remember, wear your masks.
Wash your hands. And stay 6 feet apart from each other so that we can see you again next Friday.
That's right. All right, so let's see. Let me warm up with some French stuff.
Like we said, we don't have a theme this week, unfortunately. Because it was a pretty tense week. Until Monday night, I think we were still thinking we had to evacuate.
I recorded on my first solo album, and also we did on the first Beausoleil album, U.S. Beausoleil album. It was called The Spirit of Cajun Music. We did that in 1977, and it was a song that my grandmother used to whistle. When I heard the tune, and my brother played it for me, I said, I know that song. And my grandmother whistled as well as I do.
David air whistles, everybody. This is his weakest musical. Paulette, can you whistle?
Paulette's there?
I don't know, but you're the worst whistler I've ever met.
No, I'm not a good whistler. It's called J'ai fait tout le grand bois. I made a pass through the big woods. Mainly to go find you, but what happened is that your parents sick, the dog's after me, and so forth. It's kind of but it's a lullaby, so. Kind of an odd lullaby. Think about it better. Thank you. Courtyard from the Essex. Come on, du pêche d'avoir, tout reste encore de grand bois. Come on, du pêche de Marie, j'ai rien dit sur mon nom. J'ai fait tout pour grand bois, avec ma jeune mon petit perdant de blessé. Mais Courtyard from the Essex. Come on, du pêche d'avoir, ta même une chaîne derrière moi. Avec ma jeune femme, mon petit peplum de blessé, mais plus à Paris.
Yes, indeed.
All right.
Je fais tutu.
Vintage Brazilian Rosewood Friday. So I'm playing my original OM2, made for me in 1992 or 3 by Bill Collins, if anyone wants to know, with semi-dead strings. How you like that? All right, let's see if I can find the worst of something. There's one I wanted to play. This is okay, not there. Let's go back to this. Ooh, we're gonna have a hard time today, y'all. I'll just have to make up words. I'm terrible at making up.
So tell them what happened. Otherwise, they won't know.
Well, I said.
No, but you don't know how many people came on after you said.
Oh, well, I upgraded all my my appliances, and my little iPad here will not open the program that I use that has all my set lists and words. So I have to go to the original thing to find them, which has been kind of interesting here. We're gonna look up for that, see if I can, I think I have most of it. We're gonna see. I don't know why that's happening that way. That shouldn't happen that way. Let's see, PDF songs, maybe that's it. Doo-doo, that doesn't work it either. I have songs like you would not believe everywhere, as you can probably imagine. If you used to come see me at the columns, I used to use this big notebook, which would always fall, and all the pages would get out of order. I might have to pull that damn thing out for tonight. We'll see. So we're gonna do one. Make sure I'm in tune here. Any requests? I got a few. I did get a few. This one is called, what's it called? Cher Jou Rose. And there it is. I found that one. That worked out pretty good. Just has to download it. This is a song that I learned from listening to Austin Peet, who is an accordion player and a violin player from Elton, Louisiana. And this is the song that he was kind of famous for. The Balfours took this song and made a big hit out of it, hit among traditionalists. It's called the Cher Jou Rose, which means pretty rosy jowls.
It's so romantic.
It is. It's really Cher Jou Rose, pretty rosy cheeks. It's a song about a guy who he takes a bath, he shaves, he's all cleaned up, he's got a date, and he realizes, I'm late. And when he gets on her porch and knocks on the door, he says, oh man, she's gonna cancel the date because I'm late. And she says, you're crazy. They had a great day.
What did they do? Did they go out and eat?
I don't know. The song doesn't say. Now, wasn't the apart part? Samedi après-midi, moi je me rase et je me peins pour aller voir ma chasse. Oui, comment j'aime mon temps.
j'arrive, mais j'arrive de Courtyard. Moi, je te garde au travers du clos. Moi, je la vois sur la garnie. Jolie couronne, dis qu'on était la seule de mon cœur aujourd'hui. T'en viens à partir pour aller te chercher et ramener avec lui. Pour venir dans chaque jour, toujours du monde seul.
We're all virtually clapping, dude. Clapping. Well, I'm actually clapping, but everybody else is virtually clapping.
Thank y'all.
It was very nice.
That's a good tune. I'll have to change to the other guitar a bit. Let me see. Oh, this one's got a nice tone, doesn't it? History of this guitar. It came in the mail. I was on the road, and it came in my flight case. And it was 1992 or 1993. Didi opened up the case, the shipping case. And
the box is bigger than me, y'all. So I had to get on the floor. And when I pulled out it came in a case because David always buys cases. It was surrounded by 8,633,000 peanuts, which looked like it snowed peanuts in here.
And she took it out of the case and said, "Oh, this guitar is too nice for you."
I did say that.
Yeah. But people always ask me, since I'm tuning up here, it's like,
I don't think I said that. I said it looked like it can go-go.
Well, no, you said that.
We were going to call it T-Go-Go.
It's T-Go-Go, but you said it was too nice for me.
I
had to switch from playing, I had a guitar stolen in 1989 or 88.
Ooh, tell that story.
Yeah, we played a gig in Tampa, Florida, and it was a benefit gig. That's when a lot of people had left Louisiana because there were no jobs here because the oil industry went south. And so a lot of people moved everywhere. A lot of people moved to the Tampa Bay area. And we played a fundraiser for a radio station there, can't remember the
community radio, right?
Yeah.
It's Tampa Bay's only community radio set. We don't even know if it's still in business, but they did a beautiful job.
They're still in business.
Oh, they did good. They were good. Not as great as OZ. They did good.
Gina, thank you. You don't have to do that at all. In fact, I'm going to send it back.
We give it to our next show.
Our funds are getting a little low, too. So we played, and the thing was hyper attended. There was probably 20 times more people than they expected. And
they ran out of food.
The station made a fortune. They ran out of everything.
They ran out of everything.
We made three times the amount we were supposed to. And, you know, they put us up at this Days Inn in downtown Tampa. And by the time we got to the hotel, it was way past 2 in the morning, and our flight was at 8, 7, something like that, very early for some reason. And so I decided to leave my guitar in its flight case in the van. And actually, you know, I had second thoughts when I got to my room, and I was going to go downstairs and pick it up. And knock on the door, there's two cops, and they said, your van just got broken into. So I went downstairs, and of course, they had thrown the accordions aside in the van.
Naturally.
And the drums, there were drums in the back, but they took the guitar out of the flight case. So, so I had a guitar stolen. The story gets complicated because this was Sunday morning.
Yep,
it was. I was leaving to go to Denmark to play a gig in Denmark on the Friday, on Thursday, okay? So, I filled out a police report and all that fun stuff. I thought I had insurance, but I didn't. I had insurance after that, musician's insurance, instrument insurance. So when we got to, I called up Bill Collins, the guy that made the guitar. I said, Bill, my guitar got stolen, and if I ship you Michael's guitar, he had a copy of mine, but made out of Brazilian rosewood, which is lovely wood, toned wood. I said, can you put a pickup in it and send it back to me by Thursday morning? Because I have a flight Thursday afternoon. And he actually did it. It all worked out. We sent it to him on Monday and blah, blah, blah. So it wasn't until 2 years ago, maybe three now, I happened to be messing around on Facebook. I never found the guitar, okay?
He never stopped looking, though, people.
Never stopped looking. Every time I went
never
to Tampa, I
called
up pawn shops and all that fun stuff. And I was on Facebook on the Collings forum, and this guy posted this guitar, and it was serial number 253. And I said, that's my guitar. I remember the serial number, believe me. I remember the guitar. I played a lot of gigs with it. It was a great guitar. It wasn't as good as the later ones he built, but it was a great guitar. Bill actually made it. So I contacted the guy, and it sounded like I was going to get my guitar back. And
bear in mind, this is a stolen guitar, and the guy who posted on Collins is a quote-unquote minister, and some crackhead walked into his minister office with the guitar to say, hey, man, you want to buy this guitar? And the guy goes, well, I guess I'll buy this guitar. So what did he pay for it?
Nothing.
He traded a tailor for it. And now David finds this guy on the forum, and he's got his guitar. And guess what?
He won't give it back to me.
He won't give it back to me.
So everyone says, well, no, he has to. So, well, there's a statute of limitations.
There's no statute of limitations on theft.
If he ever sells it, and I have a search on Google, you know, always there. If you're trying to sell a Collings 253, serial number 253, D2 guitar, if he ever tries to sell it, I can put him in jail. I'm going to get that guitar. Now, there's other parts.
None of this makes any sense to me. None of it.
So,
if you had a stolen guitar, what would you do?
I'd give it back to the person that owned it. So, the cops told me, because I got the police report, and I even got an updated copy of it and all this. So, it's like, all this was there. I had the police report. But I thought that I had been paid. I thought I had insurance on the guitar, which I did not. Instrument insurance. I wasn't even in the union yet. And I did after that. We all joined the union. So I never got compensated for that guitar. And that was the most that I ever spent for a guitar at the time. In 1987, I spent $1,500 for that guitar. It was a true handmade guitar. So I still miss it to this day. Oddly enough, when I called Collings Guitars, they marked down the serial number, but they did not know that they didn't mark down the serial numbers when they built them. There was just Bill and this other guy, Bruce, that were working in the shop. So the guy had sent the guitar to Collings to put the binding back on, and whoever owned it, whoever stole it, used it for a baseball bat. It was all dented up in the back and stuff like
that. We don't know that, actually, David.
No, he told me that. The guy told me this. He told me this huge letter. So.
Nobody uses a guitar for a baseball bat.
Well, and also it sang on the beach, so the neck was all... It was in terrible condition. So anyways, if ever that guy, Mike or whatever his name is, if I ever see him, I've never hit anybody in my life. I'd probably deck him because I'm really, kind of angry. I'd love to have that guitar back because I did some mighty good recording.
Because it's yours.
It's my guitar.
Also, Ben Samuel's here and wants to hear Hackamore or Voyage à Texas. So, anyway, if y'all have any ideas about getting David's guitar back, you can Facebook him, email him, or you could subscribe to his new YouTube channel.
Actually, I had a student two years ago at Delgado who was in my class because a judge put him in there to get him out of jail. And he said, Mr. Doucet, he said, where did this happen? He said, Tampa. That's I said, I know some people in Tampa.
I know people in Tampa. We have unbelievable students. Also, our nephew is a Louisiana sheriff, and he was going to go out there. The thing is, nobody knows what to do about somebody who's got a stolen guitar and won't give it back. Brooks Frank, welcome. Happy Friday, everybody. I don't know if y'all follow that story or not. It went on a little while.
It's on tape. You can listen to it later. It's going to be posted on YouTube later to get
more...
Where you can subscribe. And I've hit 1,000 people. I can start doing shows on YouTube.
Uh-huh.
I'm at 23 now. Woo-hoo! Okay, this song is called The Hippie Tayo. And the version I play is similar to Joe Falcone's and someone else's that I don't remember who it was. And like I said, my updates on my iPad won't work with my app won't work with the update. So kind of in the hole right here. So here we go. The Hippie Tayo. Say the hippie tayo sha, the cabo limo tren osha, cabo limo tren osha, he's on my limo capo dine, he's on my limo chapo sha, he's on my limo capo sha, come the boost it is osha. I say the hippie tayo, say the hippie tippy, hippie tippy, hippie tippy, hippie with the hippie tayo sha, come the boost it is osha, he's on my limo chapo. Say the hippie tayo sha, the cabo limo treno sha, the cannabis it is sho sha, he's on a limo capo, he's on a limo chapo sha, he's on a limo capo today, the cannabis it is sho sha, say the hippie tayo ya, I say the hippie tippy, hippie tippy, hippie tippy tippy, where the hippie tayo sha, cannabis it is sho sha, he's on a limo chapo today. Yo Shout.
Yeah. Jay says that's one of his favorite songs. It's from Echo, apparently. Is it?
That's absolutely correct.
Yeah, and these people know y'all's records, huh?
Y'all are scary.
I'm telling you.
We,
Angela, subscribe, David. You might be up to 24.
Yay! Tell your friends.
Yeah, we're in a little bit of a quandary. Ben Samuel, I don't know if you know about this or not, but they're gonna, Facebook isn't gonna allow any more streaming music concerts for fear of reprisals for copyright issues. So we've been checking out platforms all week when we weren't like packing up for Sally, which thankfully didn't hit us, but did make a wreck of the Gulf Coast. But if we're trying to get everybody to step up and subscribe to David's YouTube. David Doucet at YouTube. It's just David Doucet on YouTube.
You just look up YouTube. You'll see it.
Just look up David Doucet. So if you hit the little red subscribe button, we may be able to climb up from 24 to 1,000.
In a very short time.
Before October 1st.
About a week and a half. You'll also notice to have some educational English videos too. So.
Yeah, if you want to brush up on your grammar while you're there, everybody.
Pronouns and things like that. This one's for Ben. It's not the same version as the Hackberry Ramblers, nor is it the same as Joe Bonsall's, but it's Edius Nakan's version of a song called The Hack Amoro. And Edius Nakan's version is a song about an old boy who's a happy drunk of Bumbo Sugar, and he's also an awful cook. He's such a bad cook that he makes bananas taste bad. And he can't boil an egg, much like my first sister-in-law. I don't know if Michael's listening, but anyway, it's a nice old song. It's fun to play. I kind of play it in the Hawaiian style, which is in slack key tuning, open G tuning. And let's see what it sounds like. C'est le hack amoureux, ça capoté chat, capoté dans la poussière, les bananes sont pas mangeables, le candy a tombé, il était pousserie, allons danser moro, n'amuse pas quand même, allons danser moro, mais je l'ai fait chat, allons danser moro, pour manger des bananes. Gâteur de ménage. On a été chez Moro hier soir, chat. Elle nous a fait un fricassé, il n'y a pas mangeable. Allons danser Moro, mais je l'ai fait, chat. Allons danser Moro, pour manger des bananes. Pas été la TV, Zamorosha,
on aurait pensé du nom chez lui. C'est le rein qu'amoureux a capoté, chat, capoté dans la poussière. Les bananes sont pas mon genre, alors non, c'est moureux, mais je les pêche. Alors non, c'est moureux, pour manger des bananes.
Very Hawaiian sounding.
I like that.
That's good. I haven't played that in a while. Thank you.
Good request, Ben. Penny Pennington's here, David.
Hello, Penny.
Yay. And you're and Jay Hornstein just announced that you're up to 34 subscribers.
Okay. Woo-hoo!
I'm telling you, man, we're taking this thing down.
Take it down.
Yeah. Michael Brand's here. Yeah. Angela hears that there's a Beausoleil album coming October 2nd. Can you share any details?
Is there?
I guess that's your detail.
I don't know anything about that. If there is, I'm not a part of it.
Yikes. No, we don't have any details on that. Michael does have another band.
But that record's out.
Angela, you know more than we do. So,
share.
Share away. Gina Forsyth wants to play Tit for Tat. You subscribe to hers, she'll subscribe to yours. All right.
Gina, you just Gina Forsyth? On YouTube?
Is it she? Because I'll subscribe to yours anyway.
Gina would be the one, if y'all could see her comments. Did you hear that too? That you will not be able to play Facebook Live? You won't be able to play music on Facebook Live anymore.
She must have, because she's got a YouTube channel.
Well, everybody's got one, but yeah.
Yeah, Jeff, I think it's pretty too. I think it's beautiful. Hakama Rose, or that version of it. Let's see, what else is everybody doing? We're getting David's subscribers for his YouTube. Once again, if you want to help any of the Hurricane Sally folks, if you need some info, we'll get it to you. We also will let you know that extreme Southwest Louisiana is still in terrible shape.
It's bad.
We want to send out our condolences to everybody over there.
Plus the COVID cases. Because no one's wearing masks in Southwest Louisiana.
It's
real bad in North Louisiana. In the middle part of the state.
Where's Charles? What's Alexandria like?
I don't know if Charles is there.
Orleans Parish is very facile with the masks. Everybody's got them on. But a lot of the rest of the state, I heard Shreveport's doing a really good job. A lot of the rest of the state is crawled up into this anti-masker stuff. The shows. And yeah, Gina has heard about the problem.
Okay. So I didn't make it.
With Facebook. No. Because Sean Ardwin told you, right?
Sean Ardwin brought it up. And someone else I knew did too. I'm just like, whoa. All right. So this is one called My True Love. I haven't played this in a while. Playing the old hits here. My True Love is a song I learned from the Balfour Brothers. It's a song about an old boy who wants to go visit his girl, and she lives in Texas. Usually it's the other way around. I don't know why it's like this. But there's rumors, I've heard that Dennis McGee also recorded a version of the song back in the late 20s, so whatever. So what the guy has to do is, he doesn't have very much money, so all he can afford to buy to eat along the way is hitchhiking, okay? Or hoboing the rails, and all he can do is afford a half a loaf of bread and a can of sardines. So I like to sing this song because it's the only song I know with the word sardines in it, so it's kind of fun, and it's quite an interesting tune. The other interesting thing about it is the second part of the song, if you play music, is very unique. And there's no two people that play the second part of that song the same way, even though they swear they do. That's all I got to say. I even change it while I'm playing it. I play two different ways, and I wasn't even aware of it until Taylor Smith, our bass player, when we we had a bass player. I said, you know, you play that different. I said, really? I had no idea.
Angela says the name of the album is Evangeline Waltz, and it could be a Baton Rouge show. Is that ringing any bells with you?
We did a video in 2006 or 7 at Mulots in Brobridge. The video and the CD that came out of it was called Make the Veille. The guy, the lawyer that did it, contacted me a couple of months ago, and he was thinking about putting out the soundtrack again. That must be it. If you have the soundtrack to Make the Veille, it's the same album. If not, it's a live recording that we did at Mulots, and I think it was in late 2006, because it was one of Mitchell Reed's first gigs with the band on bass. Okay, Jimmy Bro, it's the full band. Jimmy Bro, Michael, me, Mitch, Billy Ware, and Tommy Alesi. And I thought it was a good recording. That's probably what it is. I have no idea what the label is, but that's probably what the record is. It's not bad. It's what we sounded like in 2006, 2007. Here we go, My True Love.
J'ai une nouvelle de ma belle, j'étais là-bas au Texas. J'ai passé par Yunis, comme moi je l'achetais 5 sous. Quand j'arrivais à Basile, j'achetais une canne de sardine. C'est pour faire mon voyage du style là-bas au Texas. Quand j'arrivais à Lake Charles, mangé la moitié. Je quittais l'autre moitié, c'était pour mon déjeuner. J'achetais une canne de sardine, c'est pour faire mon voyage d'ici là-bas au Texas. Quand j'arrivais à Lake Charles, manger la moitié de bain. Je quittais l'autre moitié, c'était le monde déjeuner. Quand j'arrivais chez ma belle, que la humaine je t'ai vue. Ça c'est bien amitié, ça va jamais oublier. Elle a mes préspérés, elle avec le lampe dans ses yeux. Elle m'a dit, mes chers vieux mecs, sauvez-moi ma chose pour me marier.
My true love, baby.
We have lots of information here.
Let's go for it.
Okay, so Angela says it lists Chad on accordion. It's four songs. They're streaming on Amazon Music, Sunset Boulevard Records. So I don't think you know anything about that, huh?
I might not be on that album.
David might not be on those four songs, huh?
I just might not be. I really don't know.
But thanks for the heads up. We'll look it up after we finish this.
We'll definitely check it out.
Anybody going out to eat tonight? Just curious.
This is one from my friend Christiane, Ms. Doucet, who's back in the United States. Oh, look, it works. I think I got it. Yay. Did it work? Did it work? Yay. Nope.
From France. She's back in the United States from
France.
I can't hold on to your sentence forever.
No, I was trying to do something here.
I know.
My app, it just opened, but now it doesn't have any song on it, so how do you like that? That's exciting.
Well, somebody asked you this week if you memorized all your songs, and you lied and said you didn't, but now you're going to have to say that you do.
Lordy, why do they make it so hard?
Lord, why is it so hard?
It's so hard.
That's why you have the blues, David.
I guess you're right. 457 songs. Can I just pick them all? I can pick them all. Select all. Let's do that.
Okay, this is the computer part of the show where you watch David play with computers and talk out loud.
I am going to select all. We're gonna.
And as boring as this is, it's still better than listening to him do the weather.
This is for Christiane. It's a song from Lawrence Walker called The Tige Noir, The Pretty Dark Eyes.
Yeah.
Parce que j'avais rêvé un déchet tige de voix qui a parti et va jamais revenir. Après-midi, j'étais assis sur mon galerie. Après goûter, le soleil a presque couché. Et je m'ennuyais, je t'adore, ma chatige noire, qui à partir ne va jamais revenir. Thank you.
Christian said thank you.
Merci beaucoup.
Oui.
Oh, I've got my words back. How do you like that?
I knew it'd come back. I knew it wasn't a permanent situation.
No, I had to delete the thing and reload all the songs in. Jeez. But that puts me in a feisty mood, so we're going to play a song that I recorded on, I think it was L'Amour, La Folie, the album. Those of you that have the albums, it's called Boudreau, and it's a song about an old boy that somehow gets hold of some rotten bananas and gets sick. Sad, huh? Is Paulette there today?
I sent her a text, but I haven't seen her name.
I'll save her.
But to see her name on my side of this thing, they have to say hi or something. So she may have forgotten to say hi, or it may be different. Paulette lives on Pensacola Beach, y'all, and although she's fine, there's no power, so she doesn't have any internet, so she's staying at her daughter's house. So that's why Dad is trying to find her. We were a little concerned about her, but she's tough as nails, so she manages to ride out these, you know, cataclysmic storms. 24 to 30 inches of rain is unimaginable, and with the entire Back Bay of Pensacola on the move. That was a ton of water.
Yes.
We've got a Macaque Sur Mondo request.
We'll see what happens. Gotta do this one first.
You got monkeys everywhere.
I got a monkey on my back. Who wants monkey?
You got
on my
bananas
back?
Everywhere.
We're doing bananas first. Monkeys and bananas.
Monkeys and bananas.
Boudreau.
Là-bas dans les magasins, juste acheté des vieux bananes. Les bananes sont du boudin, tout couché dans les grands fossés. Ma femme, les bananes, il a acheté des vieux bananes. Les bananes sont du boudin, tout couché dans les grands fossés. Boudreau, mais quoi il n'y a? Oh, Boudreau, mais quoi il n'y a? Quoi il n'y a, mais quoi il n'y a? Quoi il n'y a de vieux Boudreau? Boudreau, es-tu malade? Couché dans les grands fossés. Balançant du boudin, couche côté, côté avec ma femme. Hey, Boudreau, mais quoi il n'y a?
Indeed. Makes you out of breath.
It's time for a drink.
It's time for a sip.
That's right. Don't forget, it's sinus season in New Orleans. So, you know, if you push it too far, you'll wake up tomorrow with no voice at all.
That's right. So someone requested the monkey on my back. Let's see here. There was one. If Paulette's not there, I'm not going to play the one I was going to play. I'm going to wait till next time. Oh, this was a request from Jean Bertrand, who's playing tonight at Atmosphere, I think, in Lafayette. While I tune this guitar, I got a quick story about it. I love this guitar. I don't take it out on the road anymore because the wood is too valuable, and it's a great guitar. I take this one, which is leaning up. Years ago, I was playing at a place in town called the Neutral Ground. It was a little coffee shop, right? So I was just practicing these tunes, some of the same ones I still play today. And I noticed in the middle of one song, I heard this sound. It went like this. I said, oh my God, I wonder what that was. And I couldn't figure out what it was. I looked around. Everything was all right, you know? And I said, you know, there was really nobody in the place.
I was there.
You were there that night?
Yeah.
And so I looked down. I was during a break, and I looked down, you know, during an instrumental break. And I saw one of my tuning keys, the one for the G, had fallen out of the whole thing. It was just, and I said, it was incredible because the string was still in tune. So when I finished the song, I picked up the key and just somehow popped it in there. So that one is still kind of busted to this day, believe it or not. But that needs to be changed. That's only very strange.
But we can't go to Texas anymore because of COVID.
I can ship it to them.
That's true. I got a box upstairs that's built for a guitar. that I would love to get out of there.
I need to ship that damn thing over there. All right, so this was one by Jean, request from Jean Bertrand, and I've got the words so I can do it now. Next week I'm going to play more ballads. I got some ballads I'd like to do and practice because they're the heart of the music. This one is called La Blue, the Valse de Crève la Faim, or the Blues de Crève la Faim, which means the Starvation Waltz. And it's a lot of fun to play. And it's an interesting song where this guy he gets in his horse and buggy, he's going to go visit his girlfriend, and drives by her house and he sees her dad. He's underneath a tree and he's whittling and he's looking miserable. And he still goes visit her anyway, you know, and then he comes back the next day, he bought a new top hat, and he wants to go show his girlfriend the new top hat. And instead of the dad sitting on the tree, the mom's sitting on the porch, and she's crocheting or something and being real nervous. So everybody's worried about being hungry. Very odd song, but it's fun to play. If I can find my pick. There we go. Let's do
Charles de Kreblofer. Tu m'as pris pour voyager dans les grands bois, pour combattre la misère et pleurer la crève de faim. J'ai passé devant la porte chez ton papa était assis sous un arbre. La misère et pleurer la crève de faim. J'ai passé devant la porte de ta maman était assise sur une galerie, à pleurer la misère. J'ai passé devant ta porte de ta maison, moi j'étais dans mon bouquet. Après rouler avec mon contact.
It sounds nicer than what it means.
I know. It's true.
Because it's sort of sad.
I know.
Everybody's nervous, right?
Everybody's nervous.
Jay had to go, but he says he's going to watch it tomorrow from the YouTube platform.
Cool.
So thanks for coming, Jay. We'll see you next week, I hope. But Danny Ford just popped in. So hi, Danny.
All right.
And Christiane says you just play guitar so beautifully.
Thank you, Christiane.
Yes, indeed.
So who requested the Monkey on My Back?
I think it was Jay that left, but I'm not sure.
The guy that just left? Okay.
No, it was Jeff.
All right.
It was Jeff. Yeah.
Well, I'm not going to retune the guitar because I'm going to go do some other stuff, but I'll do it in open tuning, flat picked. How do you like that?
What, Macaque sur mon dos?
Yep.
Your monkey's coming.
The monkey's coming. Ça c'est tout vrai. Tu peux pas faire quoi la neige est noire. Peux me dire l'ouragan quand le soleil est bien chaud. Mais tu peux pas mettre ma caque sur mon dos. Tu me quittes moi sans près tous les jours. Tu vas ici à la base avec un élan. Après toi t'as tes misères. Tu dis moi je suis le seul. Mais tu peux pas mettre ma caque sur mon dos.
gave you bois café avec un homme. Tu m'as dit t'avais été juste visité. Mais cet homme était ton cousin il est mort. Mais tu peux pas mettre ma caque sur mon dos. Tu m'as dit t'avais voir ta grand-maman. Ta grand-maman reste pas leur bord, je m'appelle. Quelle petite fée, mais c'est autre chose. Je veux pas bargainer de l'argent. Mais tu peux pas mettre ma caque sur mon dos. Let's play the bar. L'argent des côtés, ils sont là. Si tu m'as dit t'aurais servi, moi je connais ça, tu vas faire. Mais tu peux pas mettre ma caque sur mon dos. C'est mon dernier bonjour et là je m'en vais. Mon vieux linge, mes souliers vont partir. Parce que je te crierai, tu juste après tu es. Mais je peux pas mettre ma caque sur mon dos.
All right, Jeff, you've got the Macaque song.
We got it.
Yeah, you're right. Sur mon
dos. That's a good tune. It's fun to play that. Play it on five different ways.
Eddie Izzo's here, David.
Hello, Eddie.
Hello, Eddie.
Comment ça va, Chu? All right. I realize.
Tuning is fun today.
It is?
Yeah.
This is what I hadn't done in a long time. And I hope I got my voice to do it.
Jeff said thanks.
You're welcome, Jeff. What are you laughing at? What's happening?
Tuning.
Y'all are funny. I have a bunch of guitars. I could put them all right here in different tunings, you know, but it's just too easy to do that. You know? It's much more fun to tune it.
Drink time. Everybody take a drink. Every time David tunes, we have to take a shot.
This one's called the Cuckoo Bird.
I go from monkeys to birds. Right?
We're covering everything.
We're covering
everything. This is a banjo song that Al and I have been playing for years. Of course, Al's in Virginia. And we learned it from listening to Doc Watson and Clarence Ashley. It's a great old-time song. Put the guitar in sawmill tuning, same as banjo, and just kind of finger pick it. I'm gonna build me a log cabin on the mountain, so high, so as I can see my baby as she goes walking by. Oh, the cuckoo is a pretty bird. She wobbles as she cries, and you never hear a cuckoo till the fourth day of July.
Jack of Diamonds, oh Jack of Diamonds, I know you from old. You've robbed my poor pockets of my silver, of my gold. Oh, the cuckoo is a pretty bird. She wobbles as she flies, and you never hear a cuckoo till the fourth day of July. Just not hungry, and they won't eat your hay. I'm gonna ride on just a little further so as I can feed them on the way. Oh, the cuckoo is a pretty bird. She wobbles as she flies, and you never hear that till the full day of July. Oh, rye whiskey, oh, rye whiskey, I know you from old. You've robbed my poor pockets of my silver, of my gold. Oh, the cuckoo is a pretty bird. She wobbles as she flies, and you never hear a cuckoo till the fourth day.
Puppy is hitting the, also you had a buffering moment there. It didn't last very long, but if y'all have any trouble catching this on your end, let us know. Butternut is having a big time today running into the tripod, so if it moves around, it's the puppy. It's not an earthquake. It's not a hurricane. It's just puppy.
It's the puppy.
It's the puppy-oid. So we just crossed over to the American sector.
Yes, we're in the American sector.
Okay.
I had a couple of requests from the American sector.
You did.
Let's see if this works. This is what I was thinking about this week. I don't know, I was sad. It was a request several weeks ago and I actually did it. Let's see if I can do it again. Don't sharpen on me. Question is, do you want to play this as a finger pick song or a it's not there. Okay, we go to backup. Maybe I won't do the song. We're gonna find out right now. Nope, it's not there. Let's try this. Woo! My deuce on me, baby. There it is. It's on. There it is. Sip.
Always, it's always
quick, time a for sip. A, I found
it's
it.
Always time for a drink.
Rather sleep in a box like a bum on the street than a fine feather bed without your little old cold feet. I'd rather be deaf, dumb, and stone blind than to know that your morning will never be mine. I'd rather die young than to live, than to live without you. I'd rather go hungry than eat lonesome stew. It's once in a lifetime, and it won't come again. It's here and it's gone on a magnolia wind. I'd rather not walk through the garden again if I can't catch your scent on a magnolia wind. If it ever comes time to go, sis, pack up your fiddle, sis, pack up your bow. If I can't dance with you, then I won't dance at all. I'll just sit this one out with my back to the wall. I'd rather not hear pretty music again if I can't hear your fiddle on a magnolia wind. If I can't catch your scent on a magnolia.
This is the Guy Clark Hour, huh?
Yes. And I just got an incredibly sad, breaking news that Ruth Bader Ginsburg just died.
Oh, no. Thank you, Justice Ginsburg. Is it Gins or Ginn?
Gins.
Everybody's called her RBG for so long, I just think of her as RBG. You hung in there with your little lace collar.
She was something.
Yeah, tough.
Poof. Gone in a minute. Just a minute like that. Here's another request.
Oh, no.
I'll have to start playing.
Why is everything happening at once?
Bang the drum slowly.
It's like the frickin' vortex of hell.
It is the Gore-Tex of hell. The Gore-Tex. The vortex. Gore-Tex.
Did you say Gore-Tex?
I said the Gore-Tex of hell.
Wow. Oh, she hung in there as long as she could.
She tried.
She did, man. She shouldn't have come back from any of those frickin' operations. Ah, Jeff, she was a lot of people's hero. God, she was something. Oh,
alrighty.
My goodness.
This was another request from my friend Doug. How do you put it? Sometimes you just got to put on those Monday morning shoes. So it's kind of a sad song in a way. It's called the Monday Morning Blues. Find my blue Monday morning shoe. Monday morning blue. Monday morning blue. Monday morning blues done run right through my bones. I've been laying in jail. I've been laying in jail 6 long weeks today. And tomorrow morning. And tomorrow morning. And tomorrow morning gonna be my trying day. I'm gonna ask the judge. I'm gonna ask the judge. I'm gonna ask the judge just what might be my fine. Get that pick and shovel. Get that pick and shovel. Get that pick and shovel, let's go down in the mine. That's the only time. That's the only time. That's the only time that I've ever felt like crying. It's a change of dime.
can you change a dollar? Please change a dollar, give me a lucky dime. Monday morning blue. Monday morning blue. Monday morning blues done suck off through my bones. All right.
There you go.
Monday morning blues, y'all.
But it's 5 evening.
That's why we have to worry about where we're going to
sit. West.
Well, maybe that's what we should do now. Why not?
Because you've done the Monday morning blues, you might as well do a Friday evening ballad.
I think that's a great idea. Hello, Butternut.
Butternut's come to sit by David.
What's the damn song called? Rifle? This is Dee Dee's gonna sing it along with us. Wrong key. All right. An odd little cowboy song from the movie Rio Bravo. Sinking in the west. That's right. Sunset now is at 7 o'clock.
Is it?
Actually,
really?
It's 6:59 today.
We're moving towards the equinox, huh?
That's right. The cattle go down to the stream. The red wing settles in the nest. It's time for a cowboy to dream. Purple light. In the canyon, that's where I long to be with my three good companions, just my rifle, a pony, and me, just my rifle, pony, and me. I'm gonna hang my sombrero on the limb of a tree coming home, sweetheart, darling. Just my rifle, my pony, and me. Just my rifle, pony, and me.
Uh-oh. Another harmonica, perhaps.
The whippoorwill in the willow sings a sweet melody right into Amarillo. Just my rifle, pony, and me. No more cows to be roping. No more strays will I see round the bend. She'll be waiting for my rifle, my pony, and me. For my rifle, my pony, and me. Purple light in the canyon. That's where I long to be with my three good companions. Just my rifle. Just my rifle, pony, and me. All right.
Yeah.
That's a good tune.
Yeah.
All right, so I wonder what key this was in.
Well, Eddie, yeah, Butternut is actually fully recovered. We have a really good person to groom him these days because the vet said we have to look for any kind of weird lumps and bumps on him, because once you've had even a tiny little cancer, it means that you might have a proclivity for it. So we're just going to have to give him lots of pets and belly rubs and play with him a lot, which he loves. We have to have puppy spa. And make sure he keeps on keeping on. He says hi to you too. And no, I don't think North Louisiana's been played yet.
Has been what?
Oh, South Louisiana, I think. It's north to Alaska, it's South Louisiana.
Who requests that, Eddie?
Yeah.
Okay, why not? What the heck?
You can do the medley or whatever.
We'll do the medley.
Yeah.
All right. Let's see if I can, because they're not related on here because I don't have them set.
Right, I understand.
Which do you want, North or South?
South Louisiana, huh? That must have been what you meant.
All right.
I don't think they've written North Louisiana yet. Nobody, at the moment, nobody wants to go.
In the key of C. And if we're real quick, we can move it to North Alaska after this.
There
you go. South to Louisiana, to the town of Thibodeau. South to Louisiana, to the town of Thibodeau. Joe Boudreau left Bro Bridge in the spring of 44 with Jean-Pierre, his partner, and his cousin Robichaud. They crossed the Chapalaya as they paddled their pirogue through the swamps and the bayous through the town of Thibodeau. They paddled through the marshlands and the swamps of Louisiana with the handles of their handmade oars making blisters in their hands. But they had to get to Thibodeau, so they went on through the swamps, cause tonight they were taking their Cajun girls to a proper sauce become. Where the bayous are flowing, the crawfish keep a growing. South to Louisiana, to the town of Thibodeau. South to Louisiana, to the town of Thibodeau.
Must can't read the.
They were going to a dance.
Then Joe fell in love with a girl they called Maureen. She came down from Opelousas to be crowned the crawfish queen. They danced and sang at Abbeville, did the same in Generette. Got married in the springtime, settled down in Lafayette. Then Joe turned to Pierre with a crawfish in his hand. He said, Pierre, you're looking at a mighty hungry man. I'll take the crawfish by the neck and tear his tail like this. Then pass him on to little Maureen, let her make the crawfish bisque. Where the bayous are winding, the crawfish they're finding. South to Louisiana, to the town of Thibodeau. South to Louisiana, to the town of Thibodeau. Way down south, way down south. Way down south.
There you go. Dusty says North Louisiana is what the hurricanes sing. I like that. The hurricanes sing North Louisiana. I love it.
North to Louisiana.
By the way, we have run out of names this hurricane season for all of you who don't live around hurricanes. We now have Beta. We've started with, I guess Alpha must have already come and gone. Beta's here, and something else is out there.
I can hear the jukebox sing, a long Victoire Bonton play. I can hear the jukebox play, a long Victoire Bonton. Opelousas sauce town, used to come this way, on his way to to sing his song. I can hear the jukebox play. I can hear the jukebox play. L'envec toi, bon temps de play. I can hear the jukebox play. L'envec toi, bon temps de play. I can hear the jukebox play. I can hear the jukebox play. Allons avec toi, bon temps de play. I push the substance used to come this way. On its way to sing his song. I can hear the jukebox play. I can hear the jukebox play. Allons avec toi, bon. I can hear the jukebox play. Allons avec toi, bon temps de play. I can hear the jukebox play. Allons avec toi, bon temps de play. I can hear the jukebox play. Allons avec toi, bon temps de play.
Got to get it, Papa. Appaloosa So Staff.
It's a great song with no words.
Eighth grade. That was such a big hit.
And in Louisiana, you couldn't go anywhere and not hear it. It was fun, too.
Oh, yeah.
Jeff is still requesting If I Needed You. I don't know if you've got a...
Of course I
if the situation with the words is a problem.
No, no, we got that.
Or tuning.
No, we don't have to retune.
Or harmonica.
Well, that was quite a trip there with harmonica. Let's see. Yes, of course, we can play If I Needed You, and then we'll probably move on to the ending songs. Song good. Well, okay, let's put this thing on there. I first heard this song from, I remember the album too. It was Doc Watson's Then and Now. About the third Doc Watson record I purchased. I bought this at Record Bar at the Northgate Mall in Lafayette. It wasn't my favorite record then. I like it now, though. It's like a grown-up man. It's not the stuff that I wanted to play. But...
Wait, Jeff's all, he's all apologetic now. He's like, wait. If you're not feeling it, it's okay.
Oh, I'm feeling it. I think it's a great song by Townes Van Zandt. So, ain't nothing matter with the tune. And I thought the Doc and Merle's version of it was awesome. And to this day, I still think they played it the way that I've heard it, which was a little faster than Emmy Lou and other people that have done it. It's called If I Need You. Come to me, would you come to me, love and ease my pain? If you needed me, I would come to you. I'd swim the seas for to ease your pain. Though the night is forlorn and the morn is born, and the morning shines with the light of love, you'll sure miss the sunrise if you close your eyes, and that would break my heart in two. If I needed you, would you come to me? Would you come to me, love and ease my pain? If you needed me, I would come to you. I'd swim the seas far to ease your pain. Oh,
Oh, she's with me now, since love showed her how to lay her lily white hand in mine. Surely you will agree, she's a pretty sight to see, and a treasure indeed for a man to find. If I needed you, would you come to me? Would you come to me? Love and ease my pain. If you needed me, I would come to you. I'd swim the seas far to ease your pain. Yes, I'd swim the seas far to ease your pain.
Very nice.
Yes.
That is a nice song. So you said when you bought it at the record bar in North Cape Mall, you didn't like the way it sounded?
No, I liked that song, but the rest of the album I thought was kind of weak. And then
was Town still alive when they made it?
Yes. Yes. In fact, if you look up Townes Van Zandt on YouTube, you'll see if it weren't for Doc Watson, you'd think anyone would ever have heard of him. All right, let's do an instrument.
JC, I tell you what, we can't send the hurricane up there, but maybe we'll send ourselves up there. We're getting a little weary. I packed up Butternut's little kit bag 3 times in the last month. It's exhausting. Hurricanes are exhausting. And Jeff, you are welcome. So what do you think, David?
It's time for some windy and warm.
It's time for some windy and warm?
Since we got, 7 hurricanes out there? I've never seen that in my entire life.
Well, yeah, 2005.
At the same time?
Well, it's... they must have been just coming off like soft balls. I don't know. I mean, you know, I don't know. Let's go back and look at them out.
In fact, we beat the numbers in 2005 because we didn't hit the alphas until October. And that would have been
Yeah, Rita was my birthday.
This would have been Rita, yeah. So what would you like to hear for the last song, Miss Cordelia?
Well, I really think This Land Is Your Land is a great way to end. I also think it's a toss-up with J.J. Cale's the Man Upstairs, the whatever that's called. The Problem, right?
The Problema.
Well. So I think you can pick either one of those. Before David plays his last song, I'm going to cut into his world for just a second. My birthday is September 28th, and this is the very first time I've ever done a fundraiser. The reason for this is because of all the hurricanes. When we saw 550,000 New Orleanians displaced into America, it was the very first time I realized what evacuees felt like. And I gotta tell you something, I hope you never experience. It's life stopped, but the outside keeps coming at you with a shit ton of negative information. So due to that, I went over to Greece a couple years back and volunteered to teach English and German to some evacuees over there. A lot of them had walked all the way from what you know as Iran and Iraq and Syria and all that stuff. But just the other day, the places where they quote unquote are camped, they're not camped, they're basically living on garbage piles, it caught on fire. And it caught on fire bad. And so now it's even worse than it was before. Like I said, it just keeps coming at you. So I found this organization called HIAS, which stands for the Hebrew Immigrant Assistance Society. They started in 1881 to help out evacuees and refugees. They're still going strong. They helped with Vietnamese resettlement after that miserable experience. So please take a look at them and share their information. And if you want to kick in a fiver, you can find me at Cordelia Ann Kale on Facebook. Mostly, I just want people to know that they're out there because I know we're all strapped, and I know we're all tired, and I know that the man upstairs has got to go, right, David? Oh, are you going to go to Woody? Okay. Thanks, everybody.
Is fitting. This land is your land, this land is my land, from California to the New York Island, from the Redwood Forest to the Gulf Stream water. This land was made for you and me. As I was walking that ribbon highway, I saw above me that endless skyway. I saw below me that golden valley. This land was made for you and me.
Shadow of the steeple, I saw my people. My
by the relief office. I've seen my people as they stood there hungry. I stood there asking, is this land made for you and me? This land is your land. This land is my land. From California to the New York Island, from the Redwood Forest to the Gulf Stream waters, this land was made for you and me. Nobody living can ever stop me as I go walking that freedom highway. Nobody living can make me turn back. This land was made for you and me. This land is your land. This land is my land. From California to the New York Island, from the Redwood Forest to the Gulf Stream water, this land was made for you and me. This land was made for you and me.
Thank you all for listening. See y'all next week, I hope. Be careful, be safe, wear those masks, wash those hands, stay 6 feet apart. And go make some, get subscribed to my YouTube feed.
Oh yeah, don't forget, subscribe to David's YouTube feed. We'll see if we can't figure out what to do. Everybody have a great weekend. If you and Christian, we'll play JJ Kale next week. If anybody needs anything for Hurricane Sally, for David's YouTube subscription, our information on my birthday charity, HIAS, please let me know, and we'll get back to you. Let's hope that Hurricane Beta doesn't, if Hurricane Beta moves us, we'll be coming to your town soon. Okay? Bye, everybody.
Oh, wow. Merci.